joined by someone who potentially could emerge as a kingmaker. Asaduddin Owaisi is now joining us of the AIMIM. Asaduddin Owaisi, what have you gone and done? You will be today called the betrayer of secularism by the Mahagathbandhan. I heard this on a channel a little while ago. Asaduddin Owaisi has betrayed the secular alliance. You've won 5 seats, damaged the Gathbandhan in 5, and the result would have been very different. Your response to what you've had, what you've seen today?
Rajdeep, it was your, you're the biggest mischief maker. It was your tweet which said I damaged in 5. What is this language from a senior journalist like you, damage? Rajdeep, I was assuming that you don't represent Mahagathbandhan. But by tweeting at you damaged 5, what is that? You know, elections are won, people, parties win, parties lose. I mean, you are assuming that that the voter who has voted for me is a lifelong hostage and who has to work as a laborer on that political party, for that political party. Then do you want to keep democracy alive, or you want democracy to be hostage to the political parties?
Let me clarify. You won 5 seats, which is a remarkable performance in itself. But there are 5 seats where the margin of victory and the votes you polled are high. So I use the word damage. I'm just asking you, what do you see yourself as someone who has prevented today the MGB from forming a government in Bihar and thereby allowing a BJP-led government? If this charge, accusation is made against you, what is your response?
Well, till the day I live, these charges, these allegations, which are baseless, would be made against me. So what? You know, it doesn't make any difference to me. I believe in India's democracy, and by contesting elections, I am strengthening the India's democracy, and I'm creating more confidence in those people who have lost confidence in democracy because of these political parties who have taken their oaths and who have forgotten them, who are not able to raise their voices and solve their problems. So it doesn't matter to me. But will Rajdeep Sardesai ask the same question to that political party? Why did you lose seats in Gujarat? Why did you lose 2 seats in Karnataka, in Madhya Pradesh? Who's responsible for that? Is OIC responsible for that?
At the moment, the focus is on Bihar. Even in Simanchal, you contested 19 of the 24 seats, and that is where that has made all the difference. Victory versus defeat, that's all I'm saying. To that extent, Asaduddin Owaisi, your critics are alleging that you played the role of damaging. I use that word again, damaging the so-called secular cause. So-called.
Rajdeep, do you know that I lost a sitting MLA seat of Kishanganj? I didn't use that word damage. Thakurganj, we couldn't win. Shergati, we could not win. No, where is an end to this nonsense that, oh, you, the whole idea of these political parties who are making such allegations against me is that I should not contest. How dare you come and contest? How dare you stand in front of us? I will stand in front of you. I have a right to.
They seem to believe that you have broken their Muslim vote bank. Consolidation of Muslim votes has not taken place.
Rajdeep, do you know that the tallest RJD leader, Abdul Bari Siddiqui, what happened?
He lost.
How did he lose? I can give you numerous examples. The problem is how and what makes these political parties say that Muslim vote. Boss, these Johnnies could not win 39 Lok Sabha seats in Bihar. And you know, if you win, oh, the Gandhi family, we won because of Gandhi family and Prince Charming. And if we lose, oh, Owaisi is responsible for that. No. What is this?
Put
an end to this nonsense.
Introspection. They have to introspect, but you also maybe have to introspect that the seats you've contested may make all the difference between victory and defeat. No. Who's your enemy number one? Is it the Congress or the BJP? Who's your enemy number one?
Rajdeep, I have said this before, I'll say it again. There are 2 sides of one coin. there is no difference. Once one destroys equal opportunity by smiling, one comes with an aggressive face. There's no difference.
So if you are in a position...
The whole idea is that you should not contest. Why is Owaisi...
No, so if you have five MLAs and today the RJD, let's say, goes up to 118, will you support the RJD? Will you support the RJD-led alliance?
The minute final result... Rajdeep, let the final results come out. Let ECI tell BJP or NDA, Gadbandhan, and all these political parties, respective political parties, have won this number of seats. Then you ask me this question. As of now, neither you know,
Access poll... Asaduddin Owaisi, everyone's eyes are on you this evening. Who will you support?
What eyes?
People's eye, there is a sense you could be the kingmaker of Bihar. If these numbers change even slightly, you could be the kingmaker. I am asking you again, who will you support? If there are five short, will you support or abstain?
Rajdeep, you know, you can formulate whatever opinion you want. But our party spokesperson, who was an observer from MIM party in Kishanganj, has given a statement that our fight has... We started our political journey in Bihar with Justice for Simanchal, which still continues. And we have clearly said that there can be no compromise as far as the true secularism is concerned, not the secularism which has been practiced so far. That is the official stand of the party. Now, what numbers every political party will get, that in itself will tell you what shape of government or who will form the government. But definitely... Lastly, please allow me to complete. I will have to speak to my state president, Mr. Akhtar Ali Man, who has won with a bumper majority of nearly 35 or 40,000. Mm-hmm. And he defeated a six-time Congress MLA who in front of Rahul Gandhi said that we will break arms and legs of Owaisi and send him back to Hyderabad. The people of Amur have shown him his place. So I will have to consult my party people. We'll speak to them, we'll decide, and definitely we'll continue. Where is the question of copping out? Owaisi it is not in my nature to cop out. I am telling you the facts.
Pawan Khera, you want to make an appeal to Asaduddin Owaisi on this show? That you would want him as an ally?
I don't want to make an appeal. That's not my brief right now. That's not my level. That happens at a different level. Having said that, he has absolute... every right to contest from wherever he wants to. Nobody is questioning him on that. But there is a mutually reinforced radicalization that the Congress is opposed to. And I accuse Mr. Owaisi and his party of being thus absolutely a partner with the right-wing, majoritarian right-wing radicalization. There's no difference. The Congress is a centrist party, equally opposed to majority radicalization and minority radicalization.
You know, the charge against the Congress is you also play minority politics and play vote banks, but you're accusing Owaisi of radicalizing. You're accusing Owaisi of radicalizing.
Nobody, I'm not accusing Mr. Owaisi of, I'm just saying counter radicalization is not the answer to BJP communalism.
Okay.
Let Mr. Owaisi respond.
That's a provocative statement to which he should respond. Mr. Owaisi, you are accused of radicalizing Muslim element. You've gone into Simanchal, an area with very poor, some of the poorest districts of the country. You've reached out to young Muslims. You've attracted them to your side. According to Pawan Khera, it's an example of radicalizing Muslims as a counter to the BJP.
Well, Rajdeep, if I am being accused of radicalizing, I mean, what kind of answer is this? I mean, it shows the intellectual dishonesty of the Congress spokesperson who I hold in high regard. If I am contesting in an election, to contest to what? To ensure that these youths don't get radicalized. You as a party could not give them a voice. And you talk about radicalization. With what cheek are you saying this? In front of your great leader, your party contestants stood up and said that we'll break arms and legs. Is that radicalization or not? Party people bet my party people in Amur, destroyed one car. What was that, radicalization or not? You know, you lose every seat, you lose Delhi, your MLAs run away to BJP at the waving of finger. What kind of politics are you practicing? You know, Rajdeep, you know, that is the problem with Congress party, that they have this holier-than-thou attitude. They falsely assume that everyone should prostrate in front of Congress party. I will not do it. Your days have gone. You must wake up. You contested 70 seats. Do you know what is the problem now? 70 seats. And you accuse me of radicalization. It is, I mean, I'm shocked by what Pawan Khera is saying. A political party is contesting election. To what? For what? To ensure that radicalization does not happen. To ensure that people don't lose confidence in democracy. And then you say that, oh, because I'm contesting election, radicalization is happening. I mean, it is a joke to say radicalization is happening because of me. Who opened the Babri Masjid locks? Who did the Shilanias? Rajiv Gandhi was the prime minister. Didn't that lead to radicalization? Who demolished Babri Masjid? Who was the prime minister? Didn't that lead to radicalization?
Fascinating.
Come on. You know, it's high time that you do something.
We are going to go back to 1989 and who did what.
I need to respond to this.
You know, it's but you can respond very quickly. Yes, Pawan Khera, very quickly before I go to the
other. Mr. Owaisi, what did you achieve in Bihar today? You achieved singularly that Mr. Narendra Modi is smiling tonight. Well, hopefully he won't smile because we are trying to struggle our way. But that's what you've achieved. That's what you tried to achieve in Maharashtra. So don't please be holier than thou and tell us that, oh, you are just fighting for secularism. No, you're not. You are strengthening the communal forces. And therefore, I accuse you of counter-radicalization. To us, the response to majority radicalization is absolute unalloyed secularism. To you, it's counter-radicalization. That's my difference with you.
Okay, final word, Mr. Owaisi. You have to go to Aajtak, I know. Final word. Do you want to settle this once and for all? What is the role of Asaduddin Owaisi? Because election after election, this is going to come. The role of Asaduddin Owaisi, is it to damage the Congress and other parties and capture a large section of the Muslim vote? And thereby perhaps become an enabler for the BJP?
Rajdeep, may I take half a second to destroy this false, specious argument given by Mr. Pawan Khera?
Yes.
Is Shiv Sena a secular party to you? Is Shiv Sena a secular party to you? Can any Congress leader can sit in front of those people who died in 93 December? Have you read the Sri Krishna Commission report? What cheek are you saying? You sit with Shiv Sena and you do a honeymoon with Shiv Sena and you talk about radicalization. You are mainly responsible for bringing BJP into power. Your party leadership is totally incompetent. And may I say with a lot of respect to you, your leadership is politically important to take on Narendra Modi. It is because of you, Modi is in power. And as far as Owaisi's party is concerned, we will fight elections, win or lose, because our main job of political party is to strengthen India's democracy. And that I will do so long as I live, and I'll wake up those people who have been wrongly told that only because of secularism you have to vote for Congress. Forget about it. Secularism can be kept alive by political parties other than Congress also. And may I tell the Congress party, mind your language. This is not how you speak when there's writing on the wall in front of you.
Let's leave it there. Elaborate in many ways much of what you've said. Pawan Khera has responded.